Apostles Peter and Paul, to all the saints in the deep Father, that I sinned exceedingly in thought, word, and deed, by my fault, by my own fault, by my own most grievous fault. Wherefore I beg, Blessed Mary, of her Virgin, blessed Michael, ever to me, blessed John the Baptist, the holy apostles, Peter and Paul, and all the saints in the deep Father, pray for me to the Lord our God.
Of the Lord. didst give to thy apostle St. Peter many excellent gifts, and commandest him earnestly to flee thy flocks, and madest thy apostle St. Paul a chosen vessel to bear thy name amongst the Gentiles. Make, we beseech thee, all bishops and pastors, diligently to preach thy holy word, and the people obediently to follow the same, that they may receive the crown of everlasting glory. Through the same thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, by whose providence thy servant John Baptist was wonderfully born and sent to prepare the way of thy Son, our Savior, by preaching repentance, make us so to follow his doctrine and holy life, that we may truly repent according to his preaching, and after his example, constantly speak the truth, boldly rebuke vice, and patiently suffer for the true sake. O God, who hast suffered the heart of thy Son to be wounded by our sins, and in that very heart hast bestowed upon us the abundant riches of thy love, grant that the devout homage of our hearts, which we render unto him, may of thy mercy be deemed a recompense acceptable in thy sight. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, God throughout all ages, world without end.
Amen.
The epistle is written in the first chapter of the first epistle general of St. Peter, beginning at the first verse. Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ, to the strangers scattered throughout Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia, elect according to the foreknowledge of God the Father, through the sanctification of the Spirit, unto obedience and sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ. Grace unto you and peace be multiplied. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy hath begotten us again unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. Wherein ye greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold temptations, that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ, whom having not seen ye love, in whom, though now ye see him not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
Thou shalt make them princes over all the earth.
stand upon this rock.
I will build my church.
In the 16th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, beginning at the 13th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time, when Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, "Whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" And they said, "Some say that thou art John the Baptist, some Elijah, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." He saith unto them, "But whom say ye that I am?" And Simon Peter answered and said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered and said unto him, "Blessed art thou, Simon, son of John, for flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say also unto thee that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven."
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Pilate, he suffered and was buried. Son, and God the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Through the tender mercy of our God, whereby the day spring from on high hath visited us. With these inspired words from Zacharias the priest, father of John Baptist, we greet every morning the proclamation of the New Testament of the Gospel of Jesus. These theological conferences meet in Dom Jean Leclerc's lovely phrase, for the love of learning and the desire for God. And we gather here at the convergence of two observances. On this eve of the 29th of June, the translation of the relics of Saints Peter and Paul, the apostles martyred at Rome, and in the octave of John Baptist, the forerunner of the Lord. And in the wider devotion of the Universal Church, the month and octave given to the biblical symbol of the Passion of God, the Sacred Heart, the tender mercy of our God, whereby the day spring from on high hath visited us, even Jesus Christ, confessed by Peter as the divine Savior. Among those born of women, says Jesus, none is greater than John the Baptist. Peter, whose act of faith at Caesarea Philippi is the riven rock whom John announces. Jesus, upon whose faith the church is ever built, is for this the greatest of the apostles. And Paul, the apostle to the Gentiles, of the universal extension of the boundaries of Christ's kingdom. Greatness of prophet, apostle, bishops, and pastors, greatness in Christ's kingdom, creation restored and renewed, is not measured in degree of personal autonomy, triumph of the will, eminence in learning, or mastery over people, capital, material resource, but in humility, penitence, trust, obedience before the Word of God. The Baptist says, he must increase, but I must decrease. Peter, depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. And Paul, God forbid that I should glory, save in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. And this one and all, a self-lowering, not in a voluntary humility, but born of the heart. On the human scale of hearts broken by reason's reasoning, of its own unsatisfactoriness, of plagues and pestilences from without, of disquiet, anguish, and repentance from within. And so thus condign to the unforeseen tender mercies of the heart of God, wherewith the dayspring from on high hath visited us, in the knowledge of grace through faith, working by love. Leaving aside the historical indeterminacy of the office of Peter at Rome defined, of Paul's challenge to his face in the continuous reform of the church, we do have a church, grace, a structure of ministry, and sacraments, historically tactilely handed down, shared with the communions of East and West, to be administered according to Christ's command and ordinance. All are built upon the apostles and the prophets, Jesus Christ being the chief cornerstone. And it is the tender mercy of his visitation, that the day spring from on high hath visited heart, shining upon, speaking unto heart. The Petrine ministry and the Pauline and the Johannine, Baptist and beloved, and the Marian, to conceive by faith in the heart, to feed, to bind, and to loose, to preach, to obediently follow the Word of God, His rebirth of imagery, His structuring of our life together in creation and its regeneration. And all this to give light to them that sit in darkness, adversity, and the shadow of death, and to guide all of our feet into the way of peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you.
Christ's holy captive. Almighty and ever-living God, who bought our beliefs, has taught us to make prayers and supplications and give thanks for us. We humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all they that do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word, and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also to lead all nations in the way of righteousness, and so to guide and direct their governors and rulers, that thy people may enjoy the blessings of freedom and peace. And grant unto thy servant Elizabeth, our queen, and to all that are put in authority under her, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, and especially to thy servant David, our bishop, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and living word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. Constantly pray all those who proclaim the gospel of thy kingdom among the nations, and all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence, they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee, thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all that who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. We remember before thee, O Lord, all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, and we bless thy thee, for all who in life and death have glorified, beseeching thee to give us grace, that rejoicing in their fellowship, we may follow their good examples, and with them be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this of all, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
You that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead the new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near to faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, deeply upon you. Almighty
Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, Maker of all things, Judge of all men, we acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever thereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who is great in mercy, hath promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with heart and repentance and true faith turn to thee. Have mercy upon us. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
And with thy spirit,
lift up your heart.
continual protection, that it may be governed by the same rulers, whom in thy stead thou hast given for thy work, as shepherds of thy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, likewise, after supper, he took the cup.
remembering the precious death of my Lord, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again in glory, do make before thee in this sacrament of the holy bread of eternal life, of the cup of everlasting salvation, the memorial which ye have commanded, and we entirely desire thy Father is, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee, Lord, that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. Remember, Lord, also the souls of thy servants and handmaids, which are gone before us with the mark of faith, at rest in the sleep of peace. We beseech thee, O Lord, that unto them and unto all such as rest in Christ, thou wilt grant a place of refreshing, of light, and of peace. And we pray that by the power of thy Holy Spirit, all we who are ordained for this holy communion may be fulfilled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. By whom and with him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are thine.
O Father Almighty, world without end.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, behold him that taketh away the sins.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
I will build my church.
Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee that thou dost graciously feed us in these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, assuring us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are living members of his mystical body, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord,
ourselves, our souls, and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee.
And although we are unworthy, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounty and duty of service, not forgetting our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Et omnes
Son and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.